Thanks for checking into another Sand Shrimp update. Now today was a dangerous day for these guys, but I think I got it figured out. I think we can pull them through. So I'll tell you about that. Plus, I did some water quality testing and I'll give you the results of that. But first, I want to try to separate these videos from the regular Angler West channel. You know, believe it or not, there might be some people who have been watching the Angler West channel for a lot of years now, and they might not be into sand and shrimp stuff. You know, I know it's hard to believe, but it could be the case. So I want to make a separate channel. Actually, I've had the channel for a long time that I set up 3 years ago that's never been public. It was just kind of a family thing. I've uploaded some videos of my niece's wedding, that sort of stuff. So I've got that channel, and I've already uploaded the previous three videos, and I'll upload this one and any more in the future. So please click on the link below, go to that channel. It's just my name right now. I don't know what to call it. If you have suggestions for the name of a channel, I'd really like to hear it. So, but go there and subscribe to that channel. So I know you're interested, you know, give it a like, maybe do some comments. Let me know what you think. And if that channel can grow and I get a decent number of people watching, then, you know, I can really pursue doing more things in this type of more detail, you know, not necessarily just with sand shrimp, but there's a lot of stuff to talk about, a lot of experiences that I've had over the years in producing Angler West that I'd like to share with you. And, you know, I think it's valuable stuff, but it's different than what people are used to in watching, you know, the Angler West channel or Angler West on TV. So I just thought maybe I'd try making them separate. So please go to the channel. It's called Justin Wolf. It's my name. Give me a suggestion for what to call it, and we'll see what happens. So if you go there right now, you might be the first subscriber, because there are no subscribers and I don't think anybody's watched the videos yet. What happened this morning was I woke up and I had a bad feeling. As I started thinking, I was like, you know what, I actually started the water about a week before I put the first shrimp in. I added some ammonia and some fish food, and just to get the filter going. And that's the right way to, you know, start a new tank. You know, what you don't do is what I've done here, is just dump a bunch of, you know, fish or whatever, like shrimp or whatever, into a new tank and start it that way. Because the tank is going to cycle. You're going to get peaks in ammonia and then nitrate. And that's just the way it is. You know what's going to happen. So if you put a fish or anything in that water, you're going to stress that fish out. You're going to take a chance on killing it. So with these guys, what happened is I tested the water this morning. The ammonia had peaked. It was up at about 1.0, which might not sound like much, but on a scale, that's pretty bad. That's pretty ugly. So that tells me these guys are tough, you know, because if like my little shrimp inside, if they got the ammonia that level, it wouldn't even come near that level before they would all be dead. So definitely some tough shrimp. So what I did was I tested for ammonia, for nitrates, and pH. So as you can see, the ammonia was that dark, ugly green color, and you don't want that. That means there's quite a bit of ammonia in there. The nitrites, surprisingly to me, but maybe not so much, they hadn't peaked yet. There were no nitrites, which means the biological filter here hasn't really started to work yet like it will. I'd say in another week or two. It takes about 4 to 6 weeks for a filter to really cycle and to become efficient. And with no nitrites, of course there's not going to be any nitrates. And I also checked out the pH. It's a little low for these guys, you know, but not bad. Right about 8, I think, if I remember right. So That, you know, I wouldn't mind raising that up just a little bit for them, just based on what I've read about most crustaceans. They want a little higher pH, but I don't think that's a problem. But I did notice this morning that these guys were a little sluggish, you know, so I was like, uh-oh. So I tested that water, and the reason I've taken so long to test the water is because I didn't have a test kit and I couldn't find one. There weren't any around here. I think the aquarium industry has really taken off because of the pandemic, kind of like fishing. You know, people are setting up more aquariums, and the stores around this area just didn't have any saltwater test kits available. So I even ordered one, and I won't get it till March. So anyway, I finally got it, and it told me that the ammonia was too high. So immediately I got out here and I did about a 50% water change, and I dropped that down to about 0.25, which is still high, but I don't want to do too much of a water change. That's never good. So tomorrow morning I'll do a water change, and then probably the next day also. So that's where we're at with these guys. So please go to the Justin Wolf page or channel, or give me a new name to call it, and subscribe to it, like it. Please like this video. And if you're not subscribed to the Angler West channel, come on, hit that subscribe button. I'd really appreciate it. We'll talk to you soon.